Show, TV's only source for all the stuff you care about. Kevin Pereira. I'm excited. Is it Wednesday?
Wednesday. Hey everyone. I'm Olivia Munn. And we're thank you from the G4 Studios in Los Angeles.
She's starting a slow clap. On the show today, we're going to try to survive death from above. The birdemic strike. Some serious crazy avian murderers will invade today's Around the Net. And then...
Yes!
Woo! All right, yeah. Lots of excitement there. Then a couple of law firms just gave some really bad feedback to Yelp.com.
Oh.
Their lawsuit alleges that the...
Oh, I can't believe it! That's bad!
Shareholder. The review site has been extorting businesses, apparently. The loop was going to try to get to the bottom of it without getting whacked.
Yeah.
I mean, killed.
And today... And today's WTF will give you a crash course in slash fiction.
Oh,
it's a genre of fan fiction that features popular characters sexing on each other, like Kirk slash Spock.
Yeah, well, we got it. We got it. Yeah. We see it.
Cool. Yeah. Plus, Danielle Panabaker from The Crazies will be here live in the studio. Very exciting. So let's all try to act sane so we don't scare her, okay? People, yeah, crazy guy in the audience who cheers loudly for everything. I'm talking to you. Don't scare our guests, okay? You.
Okay.
Thank you. I didn't want to say anything, so thank you for that.
Time now to run down the top five things on the web.
Going around the net.
Stop.
Street performer from Strasbourg, France.
Sure, Luke Arbogast looks like a tattooed Viking, but he sounds like... Well, he sounds like this.
See, normally this is where I'd, make a joke about undescended testicles, but even with that angelic girl voice of his, he could kick the crap out of me, so... Yeah! That happened.
Now, a while back, we brought you a trailer for a film about killer birds attacking humans, and today, Birdemic is about to take another swipe at us.
Oh, yeah. It takes an artist of immense talent to follow Alfred Hitchcock down this path, but... We question whether Birdemic's director, James Newens, is actually up to the task. You'll see.
The confluence storm.
I think they're eagles. What's going on?
This is Birdemic!
Birdemic.
Clearly, no expense was spared on that film. Except any expense.
Yeah, yeah. I think the only way that could have been worse would be to put, Nick Cage in it.
What did Nick Cage do to you?
In a bird suit punching women, like the Wicker Man.
That could make it more awesome.
That's what I'm saying. Well, actually, yeah, you're right. You're right.
Not worse, more awesome.
Okay, fair enough.
See?
What's Nick doing?
I'm trying to make some money.
So can Birdemic 2. They're after his plugs. Oh, no! And he's just swatting.
What did Nick Cage and Mario Lopez do to you?
We haven't even got to Mario Lopez yet, but...
Well, we will.
Yeah. Nick Cage has tried to act for the last 5 years. That's what he did to me. Same. Clogging up my Netflix.
I like to think that somewhere like in a castle that he can't afford, Nick Cage is sitting there going...
A castle that he can't afford?
He's going... Kevin Pereira. No, he's just tried to be a host for the last, 5 years. Like, I just, but not that I think that. I'm just saying it'd be nice that, you guys have this, weird thing.
Then he gets on his motorcycle from Ghost Rider and whips some chains around. No one's there to watch. He's just crying alone. He's on chat roulette. Look, it's me, really. No one cares, dude. I'm trying to masturbate on the internet.
All of his jokes go back to you. I just like the world.
I like to believe that he's after me.
Yeah.
I'm going to be looking over my shoulder now. I won't. Today's number three item is actually an epic dance party from 1991, the year of the dance.
You hear that? 1991! Yeah. Is it the grind? I love the grind.
No.
What? Stop. What? No.
No.
What? Stop. Yes. What? No. Yes. What? Stop. What? Stop. No. Yes. Oh. Woo!
Okay, well, no, it's,
That was 10 years of dance.
No, I stop.
No. Yes. What? Stop. Yeah. Yes.
Parents still aren't proud. It's not like that. It's not like the grind. If the grind were completely devoid of anyone with dancing ability and starred rhythmless white people.
What? No.
Or
yes,
half
no.
Asian people. And stonewashed jeans shaking to the Information Society's club hit Running, then yes, it would kind of be like the grind.
Did you say stonewashed jeans?
Because
now I'm interested.
Oh, yeah?
Can you just take me to a dance mix party or something like
no,
that?
No, yes, no, uh-huh. Do
yes,
it.
No,
no,
what,
that's,
no.
Just,
here
yes.
is number one DJ, Dino Papastratis.
Thank you, and welcome to another edition of Power Mix. I am the Storm, and as you can see, we've got lots of Power Mix dancers on the dance floor. So without further ado, Dino, hit me with some music. Time, and without further ado, it's time to get back into the music. Are you ready to wiggle it?
Yes.
All right.
Oh, Storm is hyping him up, and DJ Dino is still spinning, although it's now pie dough over his head for tips at Bernardo's Pizzeria. You know what I'm saying? Zang!
Really?
I'm just warming it up. You want...
Oh,
DJ Dino's still spinning. It's just at a Lady Crunch gym in Staten Island. Boom! You know what I'm saying? And work it. Really get through this one.
Really? That's all you got? I mean, you... wow.
All right. Wow. Seriously, he's still spinning, though, but it's in his grave. No, I'm serious. Actually, DJ Dino died like 3 weeks ago.
Oh. Did he really?
Yeah.
What's wrong with you?
Well, I just... thought it'd be because he's spinning, but now it's in his grave because he's. I mean, but maybe he was cremated. I don't know. I don't know where he is right now, but he's.
That.
DJ Dino!
Yay!
You forced me to do that. That was your bad.
Anna number two is a true masterpiece. Shakespeare's Hamlet is regarded as one of the greatest dramatic works of all time.
But the Second City Network thinks that this tragedy could have had a happier ending if only there was one additional character.
Meet Ophelia from Shakespeare's Hamlet. She is about to take her own life. This fate could have been avoided if she had a sassy gay friend.
What are you doing? Instead of drowning yourself, you're going to write a sad poem in your journal? And move on. P.S. This is the best your hair has ever looked.
Really?
Yes. Oh my God, I can't believe you were going to get it wet. You're so crazy, Ophelia. Oh, come on, you stupid bitch. Let's get out of here.
You stupid bitch.
You stupid bitch.
I have to say, on record right now, for everyone, yeah. Please record this. I'd actually be willing to fund a full rewrite of all Shakespeare tragedies in this style.
Yes, I agree. Except Macbeth.
Really? Why?
Lady Macbeth already provides all the backstabbing sass that play needs, right, guys? Right? So you guys know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah, I read Shakespeare. What?
How does it end?
With tragedy.
That was a good answer.
Still ahead, a musical performance unlike anything you've ever seen. Seriously.
Is it like this? What? Yes.
No, it's got 80s toys that sing. Yes. You'll see it. What? every right. Because today's number one is truly an example of what makes the internet great. Mm-hmm. See, apparently from 2006 to 2008, good years.
Great years.
There was a live touring musical starring the cast of My Little Pony.
That's true. And the story revolved around the ponies trying to gather everyone together for the world's biggest tea party.
Of course.
Between shows, the ponies blew off steam backstage by doing renditions of songs from famous Broadway musicals like Dreamgirls, Wicked.
Oh, what a magical time.
It was fantastic.
Great place. Wish we could have been there.
Yeah.
Well, see, normally, we would never be privileged enough to see such a miracle. So once again, thanks, Internet.
Linda, come with me. Think of what we could do together.
If we work in tandem, there's no fight we cannot win. Stop here with a fighting gravity. With you and I, defying gravity, they'll never bring us down.
Yeah, you know what I thought, Doug? Thought you nailed it. Yeah, look at Doug down here. I'm Randy Jackson, nice work.
It was so emotional, just so stirring. Really, I think one of the strongest performances we've seen this season. Give it up!
Well, I don't know what song you two were watching, because what I saw wouldn't have passed the cut for a drunken night of karaoke. Dreadful. Absolutely dreadful.
Well, there you have it. To vote for Princess Clomp Clomp, text PONY to 53692. Right now, stay tuned, because we're going to educate you about erotic slash fiction in WTF.
What the...
Whether you read fan fiction or not, you got to appreciate the artistry that goes into it. But even with our taste, there's some fan fiction out there that just takes it too far. Oh, is that Bert and Ernie getting it on as pirates? Yeah, we're thinking it too. What the f***? Welcome to the world of slash fiction, a unique genre of fanfic that depicts intimate relationships between various fictional characters. From Harry Potter and Lord of the Rings, to Pirates of the Caribbean and Starsky and Hutch, really? Come on, that's a bit much. Slash fiction dates back to the late 70s when fans would write erotic tributes for unofficial publications known as fanzines. To identify a slash fic, authors would always use a slash symbol in the title to represent the erotic pairing between two characters from a popular series. The pioneer of slash fiction stories is believed to originate in the Star Trek fandom, a series known as Kirk Spock. Now, we all know Captain Kirk is one smooth and promiscuous ladies' man, but have you ever taken a look at his softer side? Mr. Spock has, and according to many of these narratives, the two shipmates were in love all along. Naturally, slash fiction grew immensely with the advent of the internet and live journal websites, which is how these erotic depictions were able to quickly inspire hundreds of poems and fan art from the growing fanfic community. From desktop wallpapers and icons to sketches, paintings, and even 3D models, the Kirk-Spock phenomenon had become one of the web's first popular internet memes in the mid-90s. But the bromance did not end there. Today, there are over 3,000 Kirk-Spock homages all over YouTube, portraying the Captain-First Officer duo as something more than just friends, but rather, secret lovers aboard the Starship Enterprise. These videos parody the Kirk-Spock slash fic by taking their most passionate scenes together and setting them to insinuating music tracks like Sexy Back and, of course, Jan Arden's I Would Die For You. Ah, yeah. That was a powerful one. But my favorite is this epic montage set to the love ballad of Joy Enriquez, How Can I Not Love You? Slash fiction is just not what it used to be. With so much legal controversy surrounding copyright infringement claims, many writers today are shunning away from posting their stories at all. So I guess it's true what they say. These stories boldly go where no man has ever gone before. And while we would gladly stare at paintings of Sam and Frodo shirtless in the gardens, we still can't help but ask, what the f***?
Well, least now I know where to post my Glenn Beck / Keith Overman Brokeback stories. I'm spending so much time editing it together.
That visual just hit me.
Really?
Just hit me.
It's good, right?
I'm going to go sit down.
It's really good.
I'm going to go sit down up here.
Yeah, they just couldn't be together, even though they wanted to. And they're up in the mountains, and they're like, no, I love you. And then he's like, don't you go to Mexico. Remember that? Still ahead, everyone likes money, but Yelp might like it enough to extort businesses for it. How about that? A mobbed-up loop is just ahead.
Then Danielle Panabaker from The Crazies will be here live in the studio. I asked her what it's like to be, you know, surrounded by the criminally insane, but... Let's be honest, I get it.
What is that? Is that what I mean?
What?
Okay, later, dudes get their license to reproduce revoked on Greg Merman's Spin the Evolution. What? Shakespeare plays, you know?
Huh? Oh, lots. I know the one with Leo. DiCaprio?
Okay. We're live.
We are live.
Kristen Adams, she's going to be here with the news. Kristen,
why are you putting me on the spot like that?
Let's start the feed. It's Wednesday, February 24th, and here are your top stories. A class action lawsuit has been filed against the business review site Yelp. The suit alleges that Yelp refused to pull a negative review of a veterinary clinic unless they were paid $300 by the clinic, which, according to the lawsuit, sounds an awful lot like extortion. This follows an investigation posted last year by the East Bay Express called The Business of Extortion 2.0. A Yelp spokesperson has already responded saying, running a good business is hard. Filing a lawsuit is easy. We'll have a lot more on this later in the loop. Nintendo Wii fans are about to get a double dose of high-profile gaming. First, Nintendo has confirmed that Super Mario Galaxy 2 will come out May 23rd. Pause for applause. The game is set to have 90% new levels, with the remaining 10% being older levels with new objectives. And that should keep you busy until June 27th, when Metroid Other M releases in North America. Both games are two of the company's most anticipated releases, which typically come out near the end of the year, leading to some speculation that Nintendo has a surprise in store for the holiday season. New Zelda title? Anyone? Anyone? And you can get our take on these announcements on our website at g4tv.com. Some people are speculating Wii Fit 3. Go with Zelda. Go with Zelda. And finally, let's say goodbye to one of the ultimate symbols of American excess, GM's oversized Hummer SUV. General Motors was in talks to sell... Whatever, like, you guys all drive Hummers. You don't care. You don't care. That was a courtesy. Aw. All right. Anyways, they were in talks to sell off their Hummer unit to a Chinese manufacturer, but those talks stalled, and GM ultimately decided it's better to just pull the plug on the whole thing.
Aww.
The collapse... That's right, Kevin. Prius coming your way. All right. The Hummer follows other scrap GM brands, including Saturn, Pontiac, and Oldsmobile, and GM says that they'll be winding down production in an orderly and responsible manner and will honor all current warranties on existing Hummers. I'm Kristen Adams, and you guys have just been fed.
All right, as you just heard in the feed, Yelp is actually being sued up its comment hole for allegedly extorting the businesses that are reviewed on its website. Things are getting litigious. It's The Loop. All right, joining me from San Diego to help us make sense of it all, founder of the Weston firm, one of the two law firms who actually filed the class action lawsuit, attorney Greg Weston joins us. Before we get started, we would like to say that we reached out to Yelp to join in this discussion. We have not heard a response yet, but again, Greg, thank you for joining us. Let's start with what led to the filing of this class action lawsuit against Yelp.
Sure. One of my clients, who's a veterinarian and owns an animal hospital in Long Beach, California, got in contact with me after he saw all of these negative reviews. He contacted Yelp and said, some of this stuff's false. And afterwards, he started getting call after call from Yelp, where they basically told him that if he signed up for a $300 a month subscription, they could take care of him. They would put them at the very bottom of the page, and he could choose what reviews would be at the top of the page.
Oh, and Yelp has been accused. This isn't the first time, right? They've been accused of doing similar things before, correct?
Yeah, that's exactly right. There was a lot of articles about a year ago about lots of businesses that had been victimized like this and had even worse things happen. They would sometimes say no to advertising, and all of their positive reviews would disappear, and their negative reviews would pop up at the very top of the page, and they would stay there for years while the good reviews disappear after a few weeks.
Now, Greg, let me ask you this. Obviously, extortion, yes, we know that's illegal, but can you clearly define what Yelp is trying to provide as a service? Hey, we'll let you optimize the appearance of ads on your page and whatnot. Can you really link that to being extortion?
Well, what they are doing is telling people who visit the site one thing, that these are reviews that anyone can put up there, when in fact it's something different. It's something that's manipulated in favor of people who pay them. You put your review up there and it's positive. Whether or not it stays up depends on how much the business pays Yelp. Mm.
And Yelp has, of course, responded. They call these allegations false. Big surprise. What was the reaction to Yelp's response?
Well, you know, Yelp can call one business owner a liar, but there are dozens of business owners. Last year, many people talked to different reporters and talked about their experiences. And just today, since we filed the case, I've talked to another 10 business owners all across the country who tell me the exact same thing.
Well, let me ask you this, Greg. Like, when this goes before the court, where's Exhibit A? You know, where's the proof, the gun that is still smoking? Has anybody recorded a call from somebody from Yelp, or do you have emails from anybody from inside Yelp that say, hey, look, we'll give you a better listing, or we'll move some negative ads if you pay us?
Well, we don't record calls. That's not legal without
someone's
permission.
Oh, I record calls all the time, and it's hilarious when I give fake names. You love it.
Yeah, but we do have emails where they say these things. And, of course, if someone's willing to say under oath that this is what was told to them on the phone, and we have not just one person but dozens of business owners, that is something that I think a jury will believe. Mm-hmm.
Well, Greg, what could happen to Yelp here? I mean, obviously, If this is found to be proven true, it sounds like it'd be the end of the service insofar as much as I would personally trust it. But what could happen to the people behind Yelp?
Well, they will. What we're trying to do is have a judge order them to stop. And if anyone paid money for these reasons, to get a refund. And if Yelp doesn't comply with the order, then they would be held in contempt of court.
All right, Greg, I appreciate you coming on. I hope you keep us updated with more information as this thing unfolds, because it's a very interesting story about a service that we all use.
Well,
Greg Weston.
Coming.
Yes, thank you. Greg Weston from the Weston Firm, thanks for keeping us in the loop. Let's go over to Olivia.
I'm belt flipping. It's time to attack these WTF products. Don't you hate it when your sunglasses fall off your face when you bend over? Okay, well, I do. To make sure that never happens again, you should pick up a roll of Cool Shades tape from azumiandavid.com. Cut off a pair of shades from the strip, slap it on your face, and you're good to go. What? That's just awesomeness. It can also be used for sealing boxes. It can also keep my belt up, but, you know, why would you want to waste your tape on that? Get some glasses. Order your own sticky glasses for about $17. That's really a gift. Now, this just in, Russian roulette kills you. Okay. To play this game on the safer side, why not use the non-lethal balloon as ammo? Non-lethal, huh? The Party Roulette water balloon game allows you and your friends to test your stones by randomly popping the balloon when you pull the trigger. Now, you may think this sounds fun, but it sounds like torture to me. It freaks me the out. But if you guys want to do it, go to crankplace.com and order this balloon gun for $18. By a round of applause, real quick, who's made their own lampshade? Okay, well, that's what I thought. If you do want to make your own handmade light fixture, that's weird, you want to check out the Less Lamp from momastore.org. It's a black plaster egg that won't really brighten your living room area until you destroy it with the supplied pickaxe. Ah, now you're interested. Simply smash holes into its fragile carapace and you're ready to read your Twilight books all night long. This little guy can be yours for the cool price of $875. But it's worth it. Head on over to g42.com/AOTS for info on all these crazy products and more.
Hey, Olivia, look what I found for you.
No! No!
What do you mean, no? Come on, you gotta just...
What is it?
It's a balloon and a piece of plastic. You just talked about it about 5 seconds ago.
The Russian roulette balloon?
Yeah! You wanna try it?
You want to try? Just,
are
so,
you doing it too?
Yeah, of course I'll do it. So spin the barrel. Spin the barrel on. No, no, no. You got to spin the barrel on it. That's how Russian roulette works. Just give it a good old spin.
Don't you?
Well, you got to do the shears. Just spin it a couple times.
Is it going to make it pop?
No, no, no. See this? So just spin it. Yeah, go ahead. We're going to get through this. And then bang! Right. No. Hey, Danielle Panabaker will be here when we come back. I will come.
Oh my God, stop.
She'll be back here to talk about the crazies.
Stop.
The Feed is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Call Geico at 1-800-947-AUTO or visit geico.com.
Thought you were surrounded by homicidal maniacs? Welcome to my world. And the world of the crazies.
Let's go! Let's go! Come on! Come on! Let's go!
Alright!
Come on, let's go!
Why aren't we moving?
Call me moving, Chief!
I can't get traction.
So much for the hands-free wash. Don't judge. Danielle Panabaker, everybody!
How are you?
Thank you. Very welcome.
Welcome back to the show.
My pleasure.
Good to have you here. I have heard every bit that I've heard about the crazies has been ranting and raving about how awesome it is.
Oh, thank you so much.
Yeah,
we had
congrats.
A really great time making it.
And you wrote it and directed?
Absolutely not.
Oh, no, just take full credit for it. Who cares?
Sure,
it's
why
fine.
Not? Depends. If it does really well, I'll take full credit for it.
Then you take full credit for it.
I don't know whose fault it was.
I heard you guys had a really open set, which is always cool, that they were like, sometimes sets are on lockdown. Don't tell your friends and family you're even working on a movie, let alone Twitter it to the world. But they sort of encouraged that with you guys, right?
Yeah, it was actually really exciting. I think our film was the first that really, our film was the first that tweeted, like our film, different members of the cast, et cetera, tweeted from the film. So it was kind of exciting.
Did you use like your personal accounts or did they set one up and say, you guys use this one, funnel it through there?
They set up an account for the crazies. So mm-hmm. There was a little Twitterberry that got passed around between us.
the little tweet
yes.
bird?
Yes, we call it the little Twitterberry.
We're seeing, okay, so this is one of your tweets, DP here. Okay. Is that too? That's identify yourself.
My name's so long. Let's just be really
right.
clear.
Well,
DP.
I'm sure that led to some very interesting trending topics when it's like yes. DP from the set yet again. Was that the car wash scene that we just saw there? Frantic craziness. Was that like the toughest scene to shoot? Because I know there's some really challenging scenes in the film. Where...
Yes, absolutely. I mean, the car wash scene was one of the more difficult. It took us many, many days to film it. We were soaking wet for a lot of it. They'd given us wetsuits to wear under our wardrobe. And
you're in full-on scuba gear beneath
full-on scuba gear, like shoes, footies, the whole nine yards.
Really?
So they were trying to be really conscious and helpful, you know, even though it was freezing and
sure.
cold. So. The car wash scene was really tough, but also there's a scene that takes place where I'm strapped to a gurney bed, which was a little terrifying.
Go on. Go on.
It's actually really claustrophobic. You know, you spend days strapped onto a bed.
I've been there. Been there, sister.
Stuff.
Yes.
It's no fun.
And like when they yell break, I mean, obviously they're not going to unstrap every actor in between takes. So
that was my fear, that the fire alarm would go off and everyone would frantically scatter.
out of here.
Guys.
Yeah, crew break and you're just strapped down.
Yes. No, they were actually really helpful in releasing me whenever
good.
Necessary.
And you have earned yourself the label of Scream Queen now. Like everybody's throwing
you.
It around. Is that an okay thing for you? Do you like
Absolutely.
Having that label?
Absolutely. That's a compliment to me.
It should be. It's just some people don't, you know, like, oh, I don't want to be pigeonholed as the one who's always, and then my blood splatters on the screen and there you go. But in this day and age, I think, you know, that's an honor.
It is.
It's honor.
I mean, a lot of different horror thriller type films are getting made and I've been fortunate enough to get work in all of them, or
right.
not in all of them, in many of them. So it's been great.
And the ones we want to see, damn it.
Yeah,
that's how I will limit it. The last time you were here, you talked about being so, when you were here, you talked about being so accident prone.
Yes.
Were there any mishaps on the set?
Oh, yes. I'm still as big a klept as ever. There was a scene that takes place in a barn where my arm sort of got jammed between a wall and an actor, which wasn't totally pleasant. And then, of course, to go back to our Twittering, I had gotten hit in the mouth with a rifle, one of Joe Anderson's weapons.
Oh, yeah.
It was just a few inches off of being dangerous, but I made it out okay. But I Twittered it on my Twitter, mm-hmm. and no one believed me. They were like, ha-ha, that was an accident. And I was like, no, it really was, guys.
No, my mouth is now swollen. Look, yeah. And did it ruin any of the shooting, or did you take it in stride? And
no, the medic was great. We had lots of ice on set and arnica, and I'm a pro at fixing up.
I love it. I hear like, I got smacked in the face with a shotgun. It's cool. We had an igloo cooler filled with ice.
It was great.
We just scooted the Diet Pepsis out of the way and just put one on the mouth.
Yeah.
Did you get them back?
No, I didn't. I should have.
You have to.
Oh, well, on the next time we work
next time, just sneak up behind him the next time he's tweeting at Mr. Childs, pop him in the face with a gun, and just go, gotcha. Here's your ice pack.
Yeah.
It'll work.
Absolutely.
Again, congrats and a half on the film.
Thank you.
I've heard nothing but amazing things.
Thank
it's always a pleasure
you
to have you here.
Thank you very much.
You guys, Danielle Panabaker. She's in The Crazies, which opens in theaters this Friday. Totally unrelated to Crazies. Let's go to Olivia.
Very nice. Today's Web Tools will turn your love of music into a video game, or wait, maybe it's the other way around.
You love video games. You love listening to music. Well, combine your passions, and you've got the61.com. It mixes the best parts of social music sites with all the addictive elements of online gaming. On the 61, you'll earn experience points just by listening to music. To start your adventure, simply create an account. Now, check out your current quest list. Each quest challenges you to listen to music in different ways. Play the same song 3 times in a row to complete the earworm quest, or listen to 4 different musical moods to complete the in the mood quest. As you listen to different music and complete quests, you'll earn hearts, which work kind of like votes. When you like a song, you can choose to give it any or all of your hearts. The more hearts a song has, the more popular it becomes. With enough hearts, a song can rocket to the top of the charts, earning you respect and getting the track top billing on the 61's front page playlist. Successful quests also earn you experience points, which help you progress to higher levels. The higher your level, the more powerful your votes become, turning you into a trend-setting music mogul. The best place to dive in is through the site's main page. It plays a random popular track each time you visit. Skip songs or go back to previous ones using the forward and back buttons, and navigate to different areas using the corner menu. While each song plays, use the info panel to learn more about the band, check out their other songs, and see upcoming tour dates. Looking to really score big? Well, crank up the adventure meter to listen to new and unheard tracks. The site rewards you with hearts when you take chances, but it's not all about playing the game. While you're racking up points and prestige, you'll definitely get sucked right into the music. Find great tracks by following other users, or listen to suggested songs picked just for you. Or you can set the mood by choosing from 12 different musical styles like Party or Remix. If you like a song and want to save it, just add it to one of your playlists. You can also share your finds via email and on social networking sites like Facebook and Twitter. Feeling generous? Support your favorite bands by purchasing site credits with real-world cash. Now you can buy digital downloads of songs and albums, or simply show appreciation for your favorite bands by adding credits to their tip jar. Before you know it, the 61 becomes way more than just a game. You're giving back to a community of talented musicians, and at the same time, you're discovering great new music on a really fun site.
I want to point out that the guys at the61.com whipped up a special quest just for our viewers today.
Yeah, enter the secret code PI to unlock the AOT quest.
Yeah, there you go.
Hey, guess what?
What?
James Bond, he called. He's coming to G4.
Oh, that's right. We've got 20 Bond films, and they start airing Monday night.
Go to g4t.com/Bond for 007 videos, gadget photos, and more.
We did it!
Yay! We got Bond. Now everyone knows about James Bond. You're welcome, world. I'm glad we could give the world a taste of British cinema.
Is it?
Still ahead, people snap themselves in two on break moments.
It's cinema with like a British guy. Mm,
British
guy.
Cinema. The Queen made it.
But
Queen
first,
invested into it.
Here's Hardwick with a special gadget prawn from the world's largest camera show. It's not British.
Look at this. It's a Fujifilm Real 3D W1 camera. You're basically getting two separate sensors creating these three-dimensional images that you can view in 3D. Very simple menu navigation in the back, easy to use. You can also shoot in 2D mode. Now, what's cool is that there are a lot of accessories that you can get with this to kind of enhance your 3D experience. They've partnered with JVC, so you got a 46-inch LCD screen right there. You need special glasses for those to see your 3D images, but they're about $30. Fujifilm also has made a viewer. You don't need glasses for it. If you're standing in the right spot, you actually perceive the 3D from the viewer. That system is $499. So I just took a picture of myself in the back. But look at this. Ooh, 3D screen. What are you waiting for? This is available at shopfujifilm.com right now for $599.
Kevin says, eat me.
Testify!
Coming up tomorrow on an all-new AOTS, we'll play Modern Warfare 2 with soldiers at USO Baghdad in a new edition of Gaming with the Troops. Then we'll show you how to make lightning in a box on It's Effin' Science. And a member of our viewer army went to the 2010 Toy Fair in New York to check out the new Iron Man 2 toys and talk to comic book superstar Todd McFarlane. See it tomorrow.
Mankind has peaked, everybody, and it's really all downhill from here.
And if you don't believe us, maybe watching this will convince you.
Yuck. Sorry. All right, different cultures have different ways of showing affection. Sometimes it's a hug.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it's a bow.
Yes. But in America, we show love by hitting each other in the groin.
Right.
Okay, let's do this. Oh, God! Oh, one, two.
We do this every week, and I'm still...
I was just going to say the same thing.
Always surprised at the stupidity.
Oh.
Always. Well, allow me to call upon the trusty assistant here, the old telestrator.
Telestrator.
And we should walk through this. If there's anything you want to point out, Olivia, by all means. I mean, I want to start with...
well, of course, how you do it, just so you know.
Well, every video, you got to have the wife beater right there.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I don't mean the shirt, I mean him. All of him.
That's amazing.
It's hard to see in the shadow region here, but there is a trucker cap. Also nice here, the combo of the red sort of bandana and the cargo shorts. That's very Limp Bizkit, circa 1990
yeah.
douche. So there you have it. 1992. And for some reason, this area here is being gripped tightly. Do you see that? Do you notice the tight, firm grip there? It's actually causing the pants to ride up. Don't know what that is. It could be the Roman holiday, but someone needs to name that particular grip on another gentleman.
Why don't you do it? You're good at naming things.
It's the Roman holiday. There you go.
There it is. Well, this week's waiting system is cat hoarders, because really, why do you just care for one when you can neglect, I don't know, like 100?
Ah, that's a good point.
So how many are we going to give them?
Despite the analysis, 2 out of 5. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
There's just no...
Like I've seen it.
There's no majesty to that.
All right.
Had they buttered the floor beneath him and punched him in the coin bag...
Oh, nice.
Then
I'm with you on that.
I'd give him an extra point.
Okay, that probably could have been better. So how about something with a little more oomph?
A little more what? I'm sorry?
Oomph.
Oh, a little more oomph. How about a guy, I don't know, making a nutsack sandwich? A nutsack sandwich?
Yes, nutsack sandwich. That's a hard one to say, nutsack sandwich.
It's a nutwitch. And he's doing it with 225-pound weights.
Oh.
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 Speak to a nurse or a doctor. I have like a lump, probably the size of a penny. I got like some busted veins and stuff. I was just wondering if I was in serious danger or anything.
It's kind of like curling for frat guys. No. Just sliding the weight into the other one and right into the testes.
Probably.
Well, again, closer look, because there's some good stuff that you may have missed here. First of all, the buddy Brock Lesnar in the background. He's doing fine. Brock's hanging in there. Of course, your trusty sidekick, the old banana in pajamas.
But looks like he strategically placed everything there to make it.
Well, I don't think he meant to strategically place his high school science fair project right here in the background. I don't know what's going on there, but good leg extension. That's great. That's good. Good.
What's
big
his shirt
extension.
Say? His shirt seems pretty.
I have no idea what it says. I'm sure American Apparel is proud though. I have no idea what it is. But I'm going to let you decide.
Okay.
How many cat hoarders do you want to give him?
Well, it was we got a what the fudge from one of our
what the fudge
guys
was
out
there.
We I've never really heard that on this set, so I'm gonna say 4 out of 5.
Oh wow!
We got a what the fudge.
Pretty good. Poor kittens. Finally, folks, life is full of important questions. You know, what's the meaning of it all? How do we actually get here?
Yeah. Oh, and of course the age-old question of what would happen if you took a blow dart gun and shot pushpins into your friend's head?
Yes, that one too.
Hi, you might remember me from I got a dart in my hand and it hurt. And here's a sequel. Oh! 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 Oh!
Oh! So close, I do.
Let's see how close that is.
Oh my god.
Pull it out.
I'm in there.
Ready?
Sorry, dude. Oh my god! Dude, that was so nice. Oh my god! Izzy, what the s***?
For some reason, in a wrestling ring in their backyard, it's acceptable. But in their little opium den, it's not.
Well, I want to point out. Let me just say before you start pointing things out. Not the head, that's crazy. But the side seems kind of fun, a little bit. I would shoot you and
Oh, yeah. Oh, that seems fun. Yeah, I'd do it to you. Oh,
yeah,
great, Olivia.
I'd do it. Okay,
what if we did a blow dart gauntlet and had to run it on the show?
No, because it might...
You're running it next week. All right, I want to point out some quick things. Obviously, we have the dart in the head. That's a no-brainer. We have the Coors Light sign. Yeah, get her done, buddy.
We got the hoodie.
But here's the other thing. The upper corridor. Do you see this little path to mystery up there? What's up there?
Narnia.
Could be Narnia. Could be a ceiling cat. Could be where he keeps the MySpacers. So something going on in that region that is interesting. I'm giving it a 4 out of 5. Boom.
No, 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5. Go 5.
5 out of 5. Fine.
That's 5, Kevin.
What is it?
I'm sorry. I never do that to you, but I haven't.
You just did it.
I know, but I want it. I had to. That's
give
awesome.
Him a 5.
That's
give him a 5.
Awesome.
At least they'll never reproduce, right?
Well, not without like a lot of reconstructive surgery.
True.
Thanks, guys.
Night.
Appreciate
that. Real excited. It's like someone just walked
by. Oh, good job. Got in the windmill.
Thanks to our guests, Danielle Panabaker and Greg Weston. Stick around. Human Wrecking Ball starts right now.
Good night, everyone.
Nice to see you, Olivia Munn.
Nice to see you.